Hello everyone. So in today's lecture we will study about resonance in AC circuits, and this is the last topic of this unit. So we all know what is resonance. If we talk about any physical system, then resonance is the tendency of a system to oscillate with larger amplitudes at certain frequency than at others. So this occurs in many systems like mechanical system, optical system, musical systems, as well as electrical system. So today we are going to study resonance in AC circuits. So first of all, we will take series RLC circuit, and we will study the phenomena of this resonance in series RLC circuit. So if we talk about electrical circuits, then in terms of electrical circuits, resonance is defined as the phenomenon of exceptionally high current at a certain frequency than at others. So we can draw the circuit diagram for series RLC circuit. We have already studied this, so we will write directly the expression for current. So here we have R, L and C all in series. Voltage is V and circuit current is I. This is R, L and C. So for this circuit we already know that current is, if we write in terms of phases, then current will be equal to V by Z, and this V, value of this Z is R plus J omega L minus 1 upon omega C. So this is our impedance for series RLC circuit. So if you find the value of this current, then this depends upon this impedance. So, and the impedance actually depends upon this inductive reactance and capacitive reactance, which ultimately depends upon the system frequency omega, while the resistance is constant in nature. So if we take this Z means impedance, which is equal to R plus J omega L minus 1 upon omega C, then if we start increasing the omega from 0, then at omega is equal to 0, this inductive reactance will be 0, while this will be infinite. So this is infinite and this is 0 at omega is equal to 0. And as we increase the value of omega from 0 to higher values, then this inductive reactance will increase and capacitive reactance will decrease. And a certain point will come when both of these will become equal. So at that condition, this reactive part will become 0. When omega L will become equal to omega C, then reactive part will become equal to 0. In that condition, impedance will be minimum and the value of impedance will be Z. So at that condition, the current will be maximum. Circuit current will be maximum. So we can call that frequency as omega naught. Then at omega naught L will be equal to 1 upon omega naught C. So this is the condition when current will be maximum. So we can find out this omega naught. Omega naught square will be equal to 1 upon L into C. So from here we will get omega naught as 1 upon under root L into C. And if we write this in terms of in hertz, frequency in hertz, then it will be 2 pi f naught will be equal to 1 upon under root L into C. It means F naught will be equal to 1 upon 2 pi under root L into C. This is the frequency in hertz at which current will be maximum. So this frequency is called resonance frequency. So this is our resonant frequency. And at this condition means at frequency, at resonant frequency, the current will be maximum because impedance will be minimum. And also at this condition, impedance is equal to R. So when this omega naught L will be equal to 1 upon omega naught C, then this reactive component will be 0 and Z will be equal to R. So at this condition, when impedance will be only resistive in nature, the power factor of the circuit will become equal to the 1, means unity. It means in the condition of resonance in series RLC circuit, the current and voltage will be in same phase. So next we will study bandwidth of series RLC circuit. So bandwidth is defined in with respect to resonant frequency. So we can draw the plot of current versus frequency. So this is omega and this is current I. So we know that first of all current increases and at a resonant condition it reaches to the maximum value and then it further decreases. So this is the resonant condition at which frequency is omega naught, which is resonant frequency, and at this point current is maximum, which is I naught. So bandwidth is defined as the range of frequency, range of frequency for which the power delivered to R is greater than or equal to P naught by 2, where P naught is the power delivered to R at resonance. It means at this condition, at resonant condition, the current is I naught and is maximum. So at this condition, power delivered to resistance will be P naught. So we will find the point, means the current and respective frequency at which power delivered to R will be P naught by 2, means half of the peak value of the power. Similarly, this will occur once towards the left of this resonant frequency, and then once again it will, current will start decreasing. So we will get that point once again towards right of this resonant frequency. So at two points we will get this these points when power delivered to R will be P naught by 2. So we can write that if current is I1, means for which, so we have to find out the range of this omega. Suppose omega 1 and omega 2 is the range of frequency for which power delivered to R is greater than or equal to P naught by 2. So this range is called omega BW, means omega bandwidth. So suppose the current is I1 when power delivered to R is P naught by 2. So power will become I1 square R. So this will be equal to 1 by 2 P naught, and P naught will be equal to I naught square R. And the same will be value at I2, means I2 square into R. So I2 is the current at which power will once again become equal to P naught by 2. So using this we can write this I1 will be equal to I2, and this in turn will be equal to I naught by root 2, so that when the current will become equal to I naught by root 2, then only the power will be equal to P naught by 2. So when this I is equal to I naught the Z is equal to R. So when this I will become equal to I naught by root 2, then Z will become, means magnitude of Z will become equal to the under root 2 into R. So using this we can say that at I is equal to I naught by root 2, the resistance will be constant, means R, while the reactive part will have value or magnitude also R. Then only the magnitude of impedance will be under root 2 into R. So when both resistance and reactance will be equal to R, then we will get the magnitude as under root 2 into R. So now as I1 is equal to I2, so we can draw this, we can indicate this here, means at omega 1 and omega 2 the current is same and is equal to I naught by root 2, means 0.707 I naught. So this is the point at which power is P naught by 2 on both side of this resonant frequency. So further, if we see that from a starting point, as the omega increases, the omega L increases while the 1 upon omega naught decreases. So at this lower half power frequency omega 1, this frequency is called lower half power frequency, while this omega 2 is called upper half power frequency. So at omega 1, means at lower half power frequency, this x1, means if reactance is x1, then x1 will be equal to omega 1 L minus 1 upon omega 1 C. Means at omega 1, the inductive reactance will be omega 1 L and capacitive reactance will be 1 upon omega C. So this reactance will, the net reactance will be equal to the difference of these two, as we saw in the, in case of impedance. Impedance is equal to here R plus J omega L minus 1 upon omega C. So as this omega increases from 0, this will increase while this will decrease. It means at lower half power frequency omega 1, this difference will be negative. Means it will be equal to minus R, because this is greater than this. At omega naught, both of these are equal, but at a value lower than omega naught, obviously this will be greater than this. So we will take the difference as minus R. We have already discussed why R, because resistance is one part and reactance is another part, and when we will take the under root of sum of square of both resistance and reactance, then we will get the magnitude as under root 2R. So this equation will become equal to the minus R. So further, this can be written as omega 1 square L minus 1 upon C plus R omega 1 is equal to 0. It means it will become equal to the omega 1 square if we divide by L plus R by L, take this term here, minus 1 upon L into C will be equal to 0. So this is a quadratic equation with omega 1 as a variable. So if we do the solution of this, if we find the solution or roots of this quadratic equation, then roots will be equal to omega 1, 1 and 2. Both of the roots will be equal to minus R by L plus minus, using the rule of roots of quadratic equation. So R square by L square minus 4 into 1 into 4 into 1 into we see 4ac. So C is minus 1 by LC. So minus 1 by L into C divided by 2 into A, which is equal to 2. So further we can write it as minus R by 2L plus minus under root R by 2L whole square plus 1 upon L into C. This can further be written in simple form as minus alpha plus minus under root alpha square plus omega naught square. These are the roots of omega 1. So omega 1, where this alpha is equal to R by 2L, and we know that omega naught is equal to 1 upon under root L into C. So using these two, we have written this equation, this expression for the roots of omega 1. So we know that omega 1 will become equal to minus alpha plus under root alpha square plus omega naught square. Means we will take only positive sign, because if we take the negative sign, then this whole frequency will become negative. So negative frequency has no significance, therefore we will take the positive sign to make the frequency positive. So similarly, we can find on right side of the plot, means from here, if we apply the same condition, then at this condition, as omega 2, at omega 2, the 1 upon omega C will be less than omega L. So the difference will become positive. So as we took negative here at omega 1, so similarly at omega 2 we will take it as positive, means plus R. So that we will get, after solving similarly, we will get omega 2 as alpha plus under root alpha square plus omega naught square. So this is omega 1 and omega 2. These are the roots of frequency, lower half power frequency and upper half power frequency. So by the definition of bandwidth, omega bandwidth will become equal to the omega 2 minus omega 1. So it will be equal to 2 alpha, which will be equal to R by L. So finally we will get omega bandwidth, value of omega bandwidth as R by L. This is called bandwidth of series RLC circuit. So this is how we have found this omega bandwidth, means this range of the frequency for which power delivered to resistance R is greater than or equal to P naught by 2. So we have found this range, means omega 2 minus omega 1. This is omega bandwidth, and this for series RLC circuit, this comes as R by L. So next we will study the quality factor of the series RLC circuit. So quality factor is defined as quality factor, and this quality factor denoted by Q naught is defined as the ratio of resonant frequency to the bandwidth. So this factor Q naught is actually the ratio of resonant frequency to the bandwidth, means omega naught divided by omega bandwidth. So we know that omega naught is the resonant frequency, while this omega bandwidth for series RLC circuit is given as R by L. So this will become equal to this. It means this can be written as XL naught, means this is actually inductive reactance at a resonant condition, omega naught L, and this is our resistance R. So this is the quality factor, which can also be expressed as inductive reactance at resonant condition divided by R, resistance of the circuit. Now this Q naught is also written in terms of total energy stored and energy dissipated per cycle. So here Q naught can be written as 2 pi into total energy stored divided by energy dissipated per cycle. So how we will get this? We can write omega naught L by R. This is the quality factor, and we can multiply numerator and denominator by I naught square, so that we will get it as in terms of frequency. If we write in terms of frequency in hertz, then it will be 2 pi f naught L into I naught square divided by R I naught square, and this will become equal to the 2 pi into I naught square into L, I naught square into L divided by I naught square R upon F naught. So this is the total energy stored in the circuit, I naught square into L, whereas energy dissipated per cycle in the resistance is this. So this is how we will get this expression for quality factor. So this is the resonance in series RLC circuit, its bandwidth and quality factor. So similarly, we can study the phenomenon of resonance in parallel RLC circuit. Means resonance in parallel RLC circuit. So we know the circuit diagram. This will be like this, R, L, and then C, all in parallel. So for resonance, or we can write here resonance in parallel RLC circuit. So this is V, circuit current is I, total circuit current is I, this is R, this is L, and this is C. So from our previous study, we know that I, circuit current I, is given as V into one upon R plus J omega C minus one upon omega L. So here I am writing the directly the results. You can go to through the derivation by yourself. So here once again the omega naught means a resonant frequency will be equal to 1 upon under root L into C. And also if we find out the bandwidth with alpha method, then alpha will be equal to, here in this case means in parallel RLC circuit, alpha will be equal to 1 by 2 RC, and we will get the omega bandwidth as 1 upon RC. So this is our omega bandwidth in case of parallel RLC circuit. And we will also get the quality factor Q naught as omega naught R into C. So you can go through the derivation by yourself using a book in which all these derivations are given, and the author for that book is Vincent Del Toro. So for parallel RLC circuit, resonance in parallel RLC circuit, I have directly written the results. You can go through the derivation from this book, because this method, alpha method, has been taken from this book. So with this, we complete this unit here and also the lecture, today's lecture. And in the next lecture, we will start three-phase AC circuits.